Hi guys, welcome back to our channel. In this video today, we're going to show you how to create an online course with the LearnPress plugin. To create a course, you should open the WordPress dashboard admin, go to LearnPress on the sidebar, select course, and click on the add new part. Or on the admin toolbar, hover to new tab and select course. You can add the course title here, click to add image or video here, and write the course description here. Let's go ahead and scroll down to the curriculum part to create a new section. So, type your section name and press enter. For example, I will create a week 1 section here. Then, you can add text to the section description. Also, you can select items or create a new lesson and quizzes depending on your choice. If you click on the small book icon and add the title, you can create a lesson. If you click on the small clock icon, you can create a quiz. And that's all for how to create a course. Now we will go to the course setting part. There are 5 course setting tabs, as you can see: general, pricing, extra information, assessment, and author. First, you will explore the general tab. In the general tab, you can set your course duration, enable, disable the block content feature when your course duration expires or after the student finish the course, enable, disable repurchase the course when the course is blocked or finished or after the retest run out. You can also choose a difficulty levels, fake numbers of students enrolled in the course, and max student means you can set maximum student who can join the course. Also, it is possible to set the number of times a student can retake the course. If you enable the finish button feature, the student need to complete all items to finish the course. And if you disable the finish button feature, the student must pass the course assessment to finish the course. With the feature list, if you enable it, it will show features banners on the course thumbnails. And you can write short reviews to promote the course in this feature review box. Lastly, if you had an internal link here, the student can buy your course. It will show a more info button to redirect the link which you have added. Now, let's move to the pricing tab. You can set the regular price for the course here. Click the schedule link to select the time for sale price. And with no requirement arrow feature, student can see content of all course item and do the quiz without logging. Next is the extra information. In here, you can add some extra information like requirements, target audience, key features, and FAQs. Assessment tab, you can choose how to evaluate your student results and passing grades, such as evaluate via lesson, evaluate via results of the final quiz, evaluate via quizzes passes, evaluate via questions, and evaluate via marks. Finally, you can choose the author for the course. And that's all for the course setting. Back to the course categories. You can choose or add new course category for the course. And below is a course tag. You can add tag or choose from the most used tag. Remember to separate tags with commas. The next block is a feature image. Click on the set feature image to upload an image. And scroll up to the public box. You can choose status and visibility like public or set password and time to public the course. Finally, you can click on the publish button to finish publish the course. Well, that's all we have for today. If you enjoyed this video and want to hear from us again, be sure to hit that subscribe button before you go. Thank you.